was abrupt. Sorry about that. I don't have a fading down option. Good morning. You're listening to Wham! Wairarapa on Arrow FM. I'm your host, Hayley Gastmeyer, presenting this show, which is sponsored by Trust House. And I'm really here to tell you what's happening in the region this coming week and this weekend. I believe it's the 8th of January today. No, that's wrong. It's the 8th of February already. So we're like 5 weeks or over into the year already. I've got a guest coming in. No, I don't. That's a lie as well. I've got a guest calling in. We've got Lucy Cooper ringing in. She's going to tell us a little bit about the show that she is performing at Greytown Little Theatre this weekend. I think it's four different actors being given the scripts on the night that they're performing the play. And it's for the next four nights, starting tonight. And yeah, so it's like testing their acting skills to the extreme. But I'll let her tell you about that, because that's about all I know about it. And Michael Wilson will also pop in and join us on the show later this morning. Well, it's 8:05, and the first event up is being put on by Sunset Cinema, and it's a film called Tana. And it's at the Carterton Event Centre this evening, starting at 7 p.m. Just checking I've got everything recording correctly. That's good. Okay, so what's this film about? It's an Australian documentary by filmmakers Dean and Butler. They've collaborated with villagers in the Vanuatu Highlands who have never seen a movie to create. Whoa, I've read this completely wrong. It's a luminous tale of forbidden love and continuously evolving tradition. That's all it says about that one. But it sounds quite neat. So it's two Australian documentary makers. They're collaborating with villagers in the Vanuatu Highlands, and who have never seen a movie before. And this tale is of forbidden love and continuously evolving traditions. So that sounds quite cool. Now, I don't know if you're familiar, but Sunset Cinema, they host films quite regularly at the Carterton Event Centre on a Friday night, and you can get a membership, which is a ticket, a membership for 2019, which means you can go and see all the films that they put on. That's $80, and if you wanted just a 3-month membership, so I don't know how often they put the films on. I think it might be like once every 2 weeks. At least it's at least once a month. $35 for the 3-month membership. And you can get your tickets by going to Sunset Cinema, the website, or you can go onto Event Finder and you can click the Buy Tickets option. I believe that takes you through to Sunset Cinema. So Tana is the film being put on tonight at the Carterton Event Centre, and it kicks off at 7 p.m. What else is happening? Well, today at 10 a.m, we've got the Featherston Worn Cloth Collective, which is happening at the Featherston Community Centre from 10 until 2 today. It's $4 to head along, and it's basically a drop-in workshop and a community project, I guess, where you make items from recycled clothes and fabric, and you can hone your sewing skills. And this is being put on by Sarah, and you can catch her on 0274474959. One more time for Sarah, 0274474959. And that's if you've got any questions, but I would just suggest turning up to the Featherston Community Centre today from 10 until 2 for the Featherston Worn Cloth Collective, which sounds like a really unique workshop. I mean, remember back in the days, I don't remember, but instead of throwing your socks out when you had a hole in them, they would get mended. And that would be pretty cool to bring that back into your world, because we're very consumable these days. One little hole and they're in the bin, and there's actually a lot more life in them, and that way we can reduce our I guess, environmental footprint. So it'd be it would be good to learn some sewing skills, because you can make your own clothes that way. You can alter clothes if you change size or you want to make your skirt shorter, and you can fix your socks. Okay. Now, at the Martinborough Town Hall, which I believe is the Wahinga Centre, there is an event happening in opera, I believe, tomorrow evening. Don Pascal? Ooh. Well, as usual, I'm just guessing the pronunciation. It's tomorrow and Sunday. Tomorrow's show is 7:30 p.m. and Sunday's show is 4 p.m. I'll tell you the prices soon, but it's the first fully staged opera to be performed in the Martinborough Town Hall, which has been lovingly restored. And if you haven't been to see the Wairarapa Centre, you should. It's really, really beautiful inside, and you can just go there and be nosy and pick up a coffee. It's a nice cafe in there. It's also the library and the information centre, and the Plunket, and the toy library. So lots of things under one roof. And while we're on that note, Martinborough has had E. coli in its water for the last week. I know that all tests have been cleared of E. coli as of yesterday, but the boil water notice is still in place. So if you live in Martinborough, which you would already know about this, or if you're visiting Martinborough this weekend, remember not to drink the water out of the tap. You need to boil it first for at least a minute. But there's also massive water bladders around the town where you can fill up your water bottles. It's got safe drinking water inside. And the reason I thought about this is because the main water bladders are behind the Wahinga Centre, the Martinborough Town Hall, which is where you'll be tomorrow for this opera. So, following the success of their wildly funny The Marriage of Figaro, comes Wanderlust Opera's last offering, Don Pascal. This production, Wanderlust's third touring opera, reunites with creative team of Jacqueline Coates, who's the director, Bruce Greenfield, who's the musical director, and Georgia Jamison-Ems, who's librettist. All right, she's a singer from Featherston. Now, Wanderlust is dedicated to making small-scale opera affordable and accessible in locations outside the major cities. It's pretty cool. Their productions have been praised for drawing in newcomers to opera with wacky and witty English rewrites of beloved operas, while never sacrificing the beauty and quality of the music. So the cast, just in case you may know them, we've got Don Pascal, who's Stuart Coates, Norina, who's our local Georgia Jamison-Ems. We've got Dr. Malatesta, who's Craig Beardsworth, and Ernesto, who's Barbara Patterson. So tickets can be bought from, 0800 buy ticks. I think that's Ticket Tech. 0800 289 849. Or you can go onto Event Finder and click Buy Tickets, the button there. Now, we're looking at, it's $39 for general admission plus fees of about $4. So $39 for general admission, senior. So if you've got a gold card, then it's $35. And a student with an ID is $20. So if you are keen to go to an affordable opera, they say, at the beautiful restored Martinborough Town Hall, then you can catch this latest Wanderlust opera performance tomorrow from 7:30 p.m. or Sunday at 4, but you'll need to get a ticket. Something is happening at St. Luke's Church tomorrow, and what it is the Night Watch Love Me Tender. It's for all ages. It's a concert of Baroque music from Wellington-based early music group, The Night Watch. Love Me Tender is a concert that reflects on the many facets of love and loss, and will be featuring the joint forces of four of Baroque's voices, the finest singers,
four of Baroque Voice's finest singers, along with a collection of early instrument musicians from both Wellington and Sydney. Featuring the vocal opulence of Pepe Becker, Catherine Hodge, Philip Collins, Will King, and the instrumental exploits of Kamala Bain, Theo Small, Kat McIntosh, Annie Gard, Thea Turnbull, and the list goes on. Yeah, there's lots of words here. So you can choose from two concerts, February 9th at 6 p.m. in Greytown, and then February 10th at 4 p.m. in Wellington. Tickets are available online for a reduced price or at the door on the day, and they'll only be accepting cash for the door sales. There is also a group special available, so you buy six tickets at one time, either online or at the door, and get an additional ticket for free. So six adult tickets entitles you to one free adult ticket, and six student tickets entitle you to one free student ticket. So credit card fees apply if you are purchasing your tickets on Event Finder. Any inquiries, phone a Morgan, whose number is 027-555-6736. So that's 027-555-6736. That's a Morgan's number if you've got any queries. So tickets for this, 0800 buy ticks, 0800-289-849, or you can pick them up on the door. Now, the Greytown one is happening tomorrow. It kicks off at 6 p.m. and it's at St. Luke's Church, which is 158 Main Street in Greytown, okay? And tickets are $30 plus fees if you're getting them from Ticket Tech, or $23 for student plus fees. So you can also get them on the door. So $30 for adults, students are $23. Okay, so that's the Night Watch Love Me Tender tomorrow at St. Luke's Church in Greytown. As usual, we've got some fantastic markets happening around Wairarapa this weekend. You can pick your day, either Saturday or Sunday, and pick your location. So the Wairarapa Farmers Market happens every week in Masterton from 9 until 1. Now, you know that where the farriers is up there at the northern end of Queen Street, so by the northern roundabout. The farriers go into their car park. There's an undercover section, and that's where the markets are held undercover. So rain or shine, 9 until 1, everything you would expect to find at a farmer's market. Then also on Saturday, you can go to Featherston's Market. That kicks off at 8 and runs until 2, and that's off State Highway 2, off next to the train tracks there. If you know where the pharmacy is or the baker, just head into that car park, and the markets are behind that. And then on Sunday, we've got the Carterton Farmers Market, which is at Memorial Square. That's from about 9:30, I think, until about 12:30. And on Sunday, there's also the car boot sale in Masterton on the corner of Chapel and Essex Street. Okay, well, I'm going to play some tunes for you. Here is some Kiwi music. Who have I lined up? I can't remember. It'll be a lucky dip. I'll tell you who it is after this. Enjoy.
Good morning. business, so we have to have to do this. Meet you when you want.
They had to have bread in the Bible.
Well, people didn't have to have bread in the Bible. People didn't have to believe to be with us. I mean, we were interested in loving people as they were and being real friends with them. We weren't trying to be friendly, we were trying to be friends.
That was the Phoenix Foundation. I told you that I'd remember as soon as it started playing. Okay, now some more events. You're listening to Wham. I'm Hayley Gastemeyer, here to tell you what's happening around Wairarapa this coming week. All Plants is going on at the Carterton Railway Road. It's a place at 71A Railway Road in Carterton. They're open from 10:30 until 2 on Saturdays. Now, All Plants is a wholesale retail nursery open to the public, and it's conveniently located between Carterton and Greytown, 8 kilometres away from each town. I could get controversial here and say 8 kilometres away from Greytown residents is not convenient, and 8 kilometres away from Carterton is also not convenient, but I'm coming from Wellington, where everything is so close, you know, everything's quite walking distance, whereas in Wairarapa, everything's, you've got to drive, so I guess 8K is not too far away. All Plants is located adjacent to Matarawa Railway Station, and there's lots of off-street parking. It was established in 2016. It's a family-owned and operated business with a proven track record for selling plants online, healthy quality, competitively priced. They are now entering the retail market in a small scale, opening their business doors to the public with cash sales only at this stage. And they specialise in varieties of native and exotic trees. And they're open to the public on Saturdays. So I guess that is, quite convenient if you wanted to get your hands on some good quality native plants. You can do so by heading to 71A Railway Road in Carterton on this Saturday, 10:30 till 2, and then next Saturday, the same time. All right, so that's All Plants, open for business. Talked about that one, we've talked about that one. Yep, all right, Mysteries of the Moana. Now, this is at Wairarapa Moana, which is Lake Wairarapa. So the Lake Domain Reserve is where you want to be on Sunday at 10 until 1. It's part of the Greater Wellington Great Outdoors. It's free. So I just said it's hosted by Greater Wellington Regional Council. Now, the postponement date, if there's bad weather, is the 16th of February. So that's next Saturday instead of tomorrow. Discover the mysteries of Wairarapa Moana wetlands by following a trail of clues on the shore of Lake Wairarapa. Along the way, you'll meet experts on the fish, birds, plants and history that make the area so special, and you'll be able to see some live demonstrations. Joining us on the day will be Ngāti Kaha Nunu Ki Wairarapa, so that iwi will be there. The Department of Conservation DOC will be there. Sustainable Coastlines, Mountains to See Wellington, Sustainable Wairarapa, Wairarapa Pukaha Te Palisa Alliance, South Wairarapa Biodiversity Group, and the South Wairarapa District Council. All ages are welcome, young and old, and there'll be citizen scientists in the lake measuring kākahi, which is freshwater mussels, and supervised by Riverscapes, it says. To find out more about the kākahi monitoring, or if you want to get involved, you can contact biodiversity at gw.gov.nz. So biodiversity at gw.gov.nz. Okay, so Lake Wairarapa, that'll be a really neat event, I think. It's free. Lots of knowledgeable people and organisations are going to be there. You can learn the stories of the lake and its importance.
And it said Sunday. So it's on Sunday from 10 until 1. And if the weather's not good, then it'll be switched over to Saturday, the 16th of February. So that's next weekend. Okay. There's the Sunday sessions. They're going on at Margrain Vineyard. That's in Maranborough. So on Sunday, you can kick back and relax on beanbags or at a picnic table or on a blanket on the lawn. And there'll be live entertainment. There's live entertainment every Sunday from 2 until 5 during the summer months. It's free to watch the music, but clearly it's a vineyard and a restaurant, so you'll probably be expected to purchase a lovely glass of wine, maybe some food as well. Now we've got the names of the people performing. So Sunday, the 10th of February, so that's a Sunday, is the Goodfellas. And the following Sunday is Courtney Naira. And the following Sunday is the Nudes. We've got Sean Grant. We've got High Society Jazz Duo. We've got Courtney Naira again. The Goodfellas and the Nudes again. So it looks like there's sort of a rotation of musicians. So what's relevant? Well, this Sunday, the 10th of Feb, the Goodfellas are going to be performing. So Featherston, no. All right. Yes, in Featherston, Mahjong. That's at the Featherston Community Centre every Monday at 1 p.m. At the Featherston Community Centre on Tuesdays at 7 p.m. There's the Featherston Wahine Singers. Let's have a little look at this. So Tuesdays from 7 until 8:30. $3 on the door. Everyone always feels better after a session of singing, so come and join us. Susan Mitchell is the one leading the singing group. You can call Susan on 021-246-4884. 021-246-4884. If you have any questions, if you want to know if you might be suitable to join, so you can just turn up, though, I believe. It's $3 on the door Tuesday at the Featherston Community Centre, 7 p.m. every Tuesday. It's 8:29. Lucy Cooper, get ready. I'm about to ring you. Now, I've got to learn how to do this. We're going to plug this in. We're going to go to my contacts, and we're going to give her a bell. Bear with me just while I find her number. Here we go. It's exactly 8:30. It's not often I'm so on time. All right, we're going to give her a call. And here we go. It's ringing.
Hello.
Good morning, Lucy. It's Hayley here. Can you hear me?
I can. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you.
Good.
Good to have you on the show. It's been a while.
It has been a long time. I was just thinking about that when I woke up in the middle of the night for no apparent reason.
Hopefully you were thinking good thoughts.
I was, absolutely.
Now, are you a little bit nervous?
About this interview or about
no,
the
about,
show on Saturday?
About tomorrow night.
Oh my God, it's tomorrow, isn't it? I'm not nervous. No, I'm more excited than anything else because it's such an adventure, really. And I don't really know what to be nervous about apart from standing in front of a crowd of people with a script I've never seen before. Oh, actually, yeah, maybe I am a bit nervous.
You are so brave, Lucy. That's awesome. So this is the show's, is it called White Rabbit, Red Rabbit?
That's right, White Rabbit, Red Rabbit, and it's by an Iranian playwright called Nassim Suleymanpour, and I hope I've pronounced his name right. He refused military service in Iran, and so they took away his passport, and he wasn't allowed to leave the country until 2013 when he was given his passport back. And so I might be inferring a bit here, but my understanding is that White Rabbit, Red Rabbit, he wrote it and then kind of sent it out into the world because he couldn't, and he created this framework for it to be performed, and away it went, and it's been performed. I think by the time he was able to leave Iran, it had been performed over 1,000 times globally. So
wow.
Yeah, so the performances that will be that the Great and Little Theatre have organised for tonight, which is Miles Eckford, and tomorrow, and the other dates are 15th and 16th of February. But those performances, you know, are part of a bit of a legacy, really, of this incredible play being performed in quite unusual circumstances.
How did his play circulate?
Well, that's a really interesting question, and I'm not quite sure, because I'm a bit hamstrung because I haven't wanted to find out anything about the play, because that's one of the that's one of his instructions, is that don't find out anything about it. So what I know is what I know.
I'm guessing that so there's four actors involved, all on different nights. I'm guessing that all the four actors are not allowed to attend the other ones.
No, that's right. So what goes on tour stays on tour. Obviously, I will be texting Miles tonight after he's performed at the offering in Greytown and finding out how it went before he has too many beers. And and then I've got to keep my lips tightly sealed if I bump into any of the other actors.
But you're not allowed to ask what it was about, are you?
No, I'm not allowed anything. So, but one of the exciting things is that 48 hours before you go on stage, you get a 2-page instruction sheet from the playwright.
Yeah.
And so that was awesome, because it reads like a bit like a treasure hunt. And it kind of gives you some direction about what you will do, and gives you some hints about what might happen to you during the performance.
Wow. You're so brave to do this, Lucy.
Oh, thank you. I don't feel brave. I feel maybe a bit silly. I don't know. No, not silly. I just think, I just hope I do a great job. I just hope I do a great job. And that I imagine that every actor does it very, very differently. And it'll be interesting to know how I fit into that whole kind of canon, I guess, of performances. Wow. I hope I don't do a bad job.
Have you got, is there someone consistent that's going to be coming to all four shows, so we can get some sort of gauge on, how interestingly, because each show is going to be so unique, and
yes.
Everyone that performs it, like you say, will do it differently. It'll be, I'm sure each actor will bring out, actress will bring out a different, there'll be different, there could be a whole different tone to every performance.
Absolutely. So I think there's some real diehard White Rabbit, Red Rabbit goees in the community, and certainly a number of people from the Greytown Little Theatre community will be going every night. But also I've heard that, and again, it's all anecdotal because I'm not allowed to Google, that over in the States, when it's performed in Broadway, there were a group of fans of this play that went every night and saw a different actor every night for several nights in a row. So I think because in a way, you're seeing a fresh play every night, even though the words are the same and, the instructions to the actor are the same, the way the actor interprets that script and also the way that actor interacts with the audience, which I gather from the instructions I received last night in my letterbox, is a key part of the whole show. So, yeah, I think that's why I'm super excited. And I think on the night I will be very nervous, but hopefully just enough nerves to not make me completely crazy.
No, no, just to keep you on your game.
Yeah, that's right. Absolutely.
Wow. And now, so you'll be standing on stage, you'll be holding the script.
Yes. So I hear that what happens is as you're walking on stage, you're handed a sealed envelope. I mean, this plays to all my, missed opportunities in life. I've always wanted to be an MI5 spy, things like this. So being handed a sealed script as I go on stage.
That's going to be the most exciting part.
Oh, my God. Absolutely. I'm going to feel like I'm on an episode of Spooks. So I walk on stage, I open the envelope, and off we go. And so apparently there are things written in all caps in the script, and they're things I must stress. I am allowed to go off script, but I have to let the audience know that that's what I'm doing.
Ah.
I also, if I get the words, Nassim's words wrong, I have to go back and correct them. So it's really interesting that he, even though he's not going to be in the audience, he exercises quite a lot of directorial and authorial control, which I think is really exciting.
Yeah.
And also the other exciting thing is Apparently, every performance you leave a seat in the front row for Nassim in case he wants to turn up and watch his play being performed.
That's awesome. That is. So, Nassim, do you know anything? I know that you can't really Google, but do you know anything about his background? Is he an actor or was he a writer?
He is a writer. He's quite prolific by all accounts. I don't know whether prolific is the right word. He's acclaimed, that's for sure. So he's written a number of plays, including White Rabbit, Red Rabbit, all of which have completely escaped me. But they've been performed at things like the Edinburgh Fringe and the Dublin Fringe Festival to great acclaim. And he has... there is a show on tour now, I think, called Nassim, in which he features, or he is, I'm not sure if he's the only performer. Again, for once in my life, I'm nervous of Googling, because if something cropped up about this play that kind of destroyed it for me, yes, I'd be really sad.
Yeah.
So, but afterwards, I plan to become a bit of a Nassim Boffin, because what a guy, you know, turning this whole theatre thing on its head.
Wow, it's pretty crazy. And is it performed in different languages?
That's a really interesting question. And I don't know. I know tomorrow's is definitely going to be in English, for sure.
Yeah. Wow. So who's performing tonight's show?
So tonight it's Miles Eckford. So Greytown locals will know Miles very well, and anybody in the local theatre community as well.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I know that he was a bit like me, very staunch at not finding out anything about the play.
So he's tonight.
He's tonight. Tomorrow it's me.
Yes.
And then we have a break until the 15th, which is a week today, 15th of February, when it's Juanita McClellan. And she obviously is, I think she's the head of drama at Corinna College.
Oh, fantastic.
Lots of people know her. She's a fabulous actor and writer. And then on Saturday the 16th, it's James Riley, and he's also been in lots of local shows. He's a teacher from Masterton.
Yeah, I just couldn't think of anything scarier, but I really am in awe of you guys. That's really awesome what you're going to be doing.
Thank you.
Now, tickets, they must be, are they still available?
Well, Miles' show is sold out, which we're so thrilled for him. That's very exciting.
That's the first one as well.
Yeah, that's tonight. So if you were planning on having a bit of a theatre night tonight in Greytown, then you can't. I'm sorry about that. You're too slow.
Unless you've got a ticket. Yep.
Yeah, that's right. And so then tomorrow, it's me, obviously. And so the ticket's still available for mine, Juanita's, and James's night. Now, you can get those from the Greytown Hotel. And I'm going to give you a couple of numbers to call.
Is the Greytown Hotel, is that...
The top pub.
The top pub, yep, okay.
Yep. So you can call 06304 9138. So that's 06304 9138. Or there's another number here, which is 390-0001. And it's $20, really, really
cheap
ticket. That's
affordable, that's good, yeah.
Very affordable, yeah.
Yep.
And the cafe, so it's at The Offering, which is on Main Street in Greytown, you can't miss it.
Mm-hmm.
And the doors open at 7, and so you can come in for a light meal and refreshment, and there'll be wine and what have you. And then the show starts at 8:30, so like proper grown-up show start time.
Yes, I like that.
It's cool. And apparently the performance can go on from anything like an hour to 2 hours.
That was my next question. How long is it? So it depends on...
I reckon people must average about an hour and 10 minutes.
Yep. I'm not sure. That's your scientific analysis.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. So I don't know where I'm going to hit in that. But again, I'm super interested. I want to turn up quite early at the cafe just so I can... Maybe even, I don't know how this is going to go, and I don't know how ridiculous this all sounds, but try and establish a bit of rapport with the audience before I go on stage.
Networking, yeah.
Yeah, that's right, because I think we are going to need the audience to really want to participate. And, you know, I don't imagine that they're going to be asked to do anything that's, you know, awkward or humiliating or difficult. Just, you know, just take part in the performance. So I want to try and make my audience want to do that too.
Wow. And so people can't get, I'm guessing there won't be door sales. But,
Well, that's a good question. I'm not sure. I mean, obviously, we would love to know that the show is sold. The shows are sold out.
So the top pub, call them, the Greytown Hotel.
Yep.
And
304-9138 or 390-0001.
Are they both numbers for the top pub?
I'm not sure what that second number is, but they're both numbers where you can get your $20 ticket.
Perfect. Awesome. Oh, Lucy, I'm hoping to come along. It sounds absolutely amazing, very exciting, and I just wish you all the best and the other actors as well.
Wonderful. Thank you.
Yeah.
And it would be lovely to see you in the audience. As I say, there's three nights still available this Saturday and next Friday and Saturday. And everyone's welcome and should be something really special for the community.
Fantastic. All right, Lucy, look, it's been a pleasure talking with you. Thank you so much for telling us about White Rabbit, Red Rabbit. I'm going to go away and I'll be Googling it straight after this. But I don't want to spoil the surprise either. So I wish you all the best.
Wonderful. Thanks for the opportunity, Hayley, and have a great day.
You too, Lucy. See you later.
Cheers. Bye-bye.
Bye. Cool. That went pretty smoothly. Did it sound like it went smoothly? What are you on, D?
I believe I am. Yep. It did sound very good, Hayley. I just popped in to say a couple of things. I just phoned that second number, and that's Miles's number, and I've booked for tomorrow night. Now, when I say tomorrow night, this is the other reason I'm in. Remember that this program is repeated on Saturdays, so by tomorrow night, we mean Saturday night, and by tonight, we mean Friday night.
Got it. So you're going to Lucy's one?
I'm going to Lucy's one on Saturday night.
And so we want to be calling the Greytown Hotel to book tickets to that.
Yeah. All that second number, which seems to be Miles' number, although
so he'll be taking bookings
work
for the others.
It's his home phone number, so he might be off to work, you know.
Mm.
Yeah.
All right. Do you want to talk about this one?
Well, it's a week away, isn't it? What's the date today?
Today's the 8th, I believe, or is it the 9th? It's the 8th.
Yeah. No, this is a week away, but, you know, it's always worth, because your calendar gets filled up, doesn't it? Mm-hmm. All right. So this is the Wairarapa branch of the New Zealand Society of Genealogists. Notice I said genealogist and not genealogist, like some people say.
Genealogist. I say genealogist. Is that wrong?
Genealogist.
Genealogist?
Yeah.
My mum's into genealogy.
Good. Yeah. We're all into it in the sense that we've all been born and came from somewhere.
Exactly. But yeah. Yeah, there's, I guess.
But more. Your mum does more.
She does very intense research. Yes, I should pick her brain one day because I know nothing about where I've come from, really.
Yeah, my family's never been very good at that. My wife's family, Joanne, they know everything. Mm. Well, going way back. It's amazing. But anyway, they're having a meeting. They do that from time to time and the public are invited. This is the one on Sunday the 17th of February. So that's some time away. Did you notice I said February? And that's because, you know, I think it's a great thing that Te Reo Māori is so prevalent in our society now that we find ourselves pronouncing
English
words in a Māori way. Yeah, great. Anyway, on Sunday the 17th of February, they've got a meeting at the research rooms, which is on Queen Street, just over the road from where we used to be.
Is it at the archives?
No.
Oh, it's next to it.
It's one away from it. You know, there's a shop and then another one. Mm. And Rowan Carroll will be there, and she's going to give a presentation on police gazettes and old mugshots.
What's a police gazette?
It's like their newspaper, right?
Oh,
but it might
yes.
have things like, watch out for this because this person's dangerous, or we apprehended a person just the other day.
That's a good accent. I like that.
Yeah, that was a standard one in Masterton in the olden days. And old mugshots. So, you know, go along, you might see yourself or a member of your family. You go, oh no, that's Granddad. What did he do? Anyway, she's the director of the New Zealand Police Museum.
Wow, that's cool. Do you know where the New Zealand Police Museum is?
I'm going to take a wild guess and say New Zealand.
Ooh.
But that's the best I know. Yeah. Doors are open at 1 o'clock, but as I say, it's a whole week away yet, and they have a cup of tea and a chat afterwards. If you're a member of the New Zealand Society of Genealogists, it's free. If you're a member of the public, it's $4, which is pretty cheap because you get a cuppa as well.
That's not bad.
Yeah. That's all I got, Haley.
Cool. Well, leave that somewhere for me and I will talk about it next week again.
There you go.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Michael.
Apart from that, I don't know what's going on. You're good at that. You know everything.
I've got a few more things to talk about.
Mm-hmm.
Art for everyone. If you want to get involved, if you want to get your paintbrush out, you can head to the Featherston Community Centre every Tuesday night at 7 p.m. Yep, art for everyone. But then there's also art at the Featherston Community Centre on Tuesdays again at 10 a.m. So it looks like there's a class Tuesday. Community art is 10 a.m. Tuesday, and then art for everyone is 7 p.m. Tuesday. So art's happening in Featherston on Tuesdays.
Right, good.
Kia kaha aki. That's at the YMCA Masterton. I better click on this one just to see what it's all about. Looks like it's on Tuesday, the 12th of February, from 10:30. The YMCA in Masterton is on Queen Street. It looks like something's happening there every Tuesday at 10:30. It's $2 per child. Kia Kaha Aki is a fundamental movement-free play program for kids aged between 0 and 6.
Great.
So you can't go.
Okay. Kia Kaha Aki, which sort of means, give it heaps forever. Ake means again and again or forever, I think.
I see. Cool.
I could be wrong.
There's heaps of sensory objects to play with, plus light refreshments for parents. So come down and check it out, and you can go onto the Facebook page, which is looks like there's YMCA Masterton is the Facebook page. So that's something cool for you to do with your little ones on Tuesday mornings. Okay, yep, Alpha Course. This is happening at St. Andrew's Church in Martinborough on Wednesday. That's next Wednesday the 13th, 6:30 to 9. Alpha is a series of sessions exploring the Christian faith. Each talk looks at a different question around faith and is designed to create conversation. Alpha is run all around the globe and everyone's welcome. It runs in cafes, churches, universities, homes, and no two alphas look the same, but generally they have three things in common: food, talk, and good conversation. So if you're interested, if that sounds like something you'd be interested in, exploring faith and life and meaning, then head to the St. Andrew's Church on Dublin Street in Martinborough. Looks like it's every Wednesday for the next few weeks, from 6:30 until 9 at night. Cool. All right, I'm pretty sure we're nearly at the end of all of our events and it's time to go. We've got Opportunity presenting Luck of the Irish. Oh, do that better than I did. Luck of the Irish. In the correct accent.
What? Luck of the Irish? To be sure it is. Doing Luck of the Irish. And I'm thinking it's probably the Southern Irish as opposed to Northern Irish, which is like that.
Gosh, you're good, aren't you? You'd think that you were an actor in a past life.
Who would have thought?
Look, Luck of the Irish.
Yeah.
On Wednesday at 11, it's at the it's at the Carterton Event Centre.
Yeah. They give you a lunch tickets and everything, don't they?
You do. You get a lunch. So your ticket includes a lunch and the show. They're touring New Zealand through January and February, with bewitching ballads to stir the soul, frantic fiddling, jigs, jokes, and jollity. Luck of the Irish will leave you with a bitter of Ireland in your heart. I'm going to Ireland soon.
Are you?
Just for 3 days.
What?
I'm going to Europe and I'm dropping Ireland in there. I'm going to Dublin to see where my granddad's from.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
Bit of genealogy there.
Yes, exactly. So if you want to book your ticket to Luck of the Irish, you can call 0508 266 237. And that's 0508 266 237. Or you can visit the website. And the website is Opportunity. It just says Opportunity official website. So I guess Google Opportunity and look for the performances at the Carterton Event Centre. So that's next Wednesday. Quickly, and two more events. Hatha Yoga with Nikki. She's doing yoga at the Featherston Community Centre every Wednesday at 7 p.m. And then we've got the ukulele group there at the Featherston Community Centre on Wednesdays at 1.
So it looks like there's lots going on at the Featherston Community Centre. They're good at advertising their projects. Quickly, weather, what's happening this weekend? All right. Looks like, well, today the situation is a high over the Chatham Islands extends a ridge back over New Zealand. And on that note, I'm thinking of everyone in Nelson with those fires. Teapot Valley is under threat at the moment, and that's where I spent every school holidays when I was a kid growing up, because my uncle, he was the manager of the camp, the children's camp there, and he's a police officer now, and his house isn't far. Like, they sent a photo from his house last night, and there's just smoke surrounding it, but I don't think they're in the firing line yet. But I know that there's lots of people being evacuated, and yeah, it's yeah. pretty must
that
be
was a crucial factor, isn't it?
Must be pretty scary.
Yeah.
So fingers crossed that the wind dies down and they put it out, because, you know, good on the emergency services that are working so hard down there, and they're doing a pretty good job by the sounds of it, even though the sort of weather's out of their control. Only one house has been destroyed so far, and some animals have been harmed, but that's a pretty good result for such a crazy big fire over, like, this might be its fourth day, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think they're doing amazing work.
Mm. Now, in Wairarapa today, we've got a cloudy day with a few showers about the coast, becoming fine from afternoon and northeasterlies.
What did you say today? Where are you talking Friday here?
Today is Friday.
Yeah.
Good one. We do need to clarify, because when
it'll have been yesterday.
Exactly. So today, 24 degrees is what we're looking at. Tomorrow, fine, apart from evening cloud and northerlies, and we're looking at a high of 27 tomorrow. Sunday, mainly fine with northerlies, a high of 29. And in Tararua Forest Park today, fine, apart from some morning cloud. And tomorrow is fine in the Tararua Forest Park. Yeah. All right, everyone. Thank you very much for listening to Wham Wairarapa with me, Hayley Gastmeyer. And thank you, Trust House, for sponsoring the show. And thanks for joining us, Michael. It's been a pleasure.
You're going to have to run, Hayley.
I am going to have to run. I hope you all have a good day, a safe weekend, and a great week. And I'll be back again next Friday. See you then.
Bye.
Bye.